Now, first let us see the holdings. All the tools you will see, don't worry. So, first we see the, you see, why marking tools are not shown first, why the holding tools are shown first. First, the workpiece is rigidly held on the table, after that marking tools, measuring tools, all the things we use. So, in a systematic way, we are using that one, we are discussing. So, holding tools. So, holding tools generally, which are used to hold the objects and other things. So, in the carpentry work also, in the second unit also, I told you what are the holding tools. So, for simple thing is, if you have, once again I am telling you, if you have a pen, inside you have a refill. Refill diameter is very less. So, that is why we cannot use the refill to write. We can write, but it is not comfort to us. It is even it is not difficult to us. We can write, but it is not comfort. So that is what we are doing. That refill is placed in a pen, and then we are writing. So where the pen is holding tool. So like that here also. What are the holding tools in this fitting work? We see now. See, this is a primary holding device called as bench vise. So most of the workshops you will see this kind of device or vise to hold the work. You see this? So this is the fixed jaw. This one is fixed jaw. This is mobile jaw. Before seeing this one, this fixed jaw can be said as this is an integral part, base and the fixed jaw. See this one, base and fixed jaw is a single part. So at center we have one square hole. In the square hole, this is inserted. This one is inserted. Now if we see this one, this fixed jaw along with the base is an integral part. Here we have one hole. Similarly, other side also we have one hole. So this one is fixed on a bench. So for suppose if you see this one is a table, this one is a table. So in this direction, see this one, here we have one hole, backside also we have another hole. With the help of the two holes, this is fixed on the table. Then you have in this direction fixed jaw, this one is mobile jaw. When you rotate the screw, here see this one, you have a spindle. So when the spindle is rotated, this mobile jaw is coming towards the fixed jaw. Look, fixed jaw where we have, this is all on the table. This is mobile jaw. By rotating this handle, so this is coming in this direction between the, see this one, this is fixed jaw, this one is mobile jaw. So when the component is placed here, this is moved towards that one. If any component held like this, so rigidly this is held. This is the metal piece which you want to work. Now see this one, this is base is held on the table. So where we have the hole, through that hole bolt and nuts are used, and this one is this base is rigidly held on the table. Next one, this fixed jaw is having a hole here. This is square hole. In the square hole, the square piece of the mobile jaw. So this mobile jaw is having a square projection. This square projection is inserted in the square hole. So where we have the spindle, if you rotate the spindle, this mobile jaw is moved inward and outward. When it is moved inward, if any component is placed here between the fixed jaw and mobile jaw, the workpiece is rigidly held. See this one? Bench vise commonly used in the fitting shop for holding a variety of jobs. Not only in the fitting shop. Even in the carpentry also, we use same thing. Even in the metal cutting, some machine shops are there. There also, for some special purpose applications, this bench vise is used in many applications. Even on the metal cutting machines also, this kinds of bench vise is used. So especially in the fitting shop, without bench vise you cannot do the work. So if you see the carpentry work, we can perform that one on the floor also. So C clamp, another clamps are there. Using those things on the floor also we can perform. But these fitting works cannot be done. Where you must need this kind of bench vise. In the bench vise, the component is placed. That is between the fixed and movable jaws, the components are located. This is compulsory. Next one, this is V block with clamp. See, this is on before slide. We see once again. If we see in this process, we can hold only flat surfaces. So flat surface means this kind of surfaces. So this is one flat, this is another flat. So we can hold like this. This is fixed jaw, this is movable jaw, like that we are holding. Okay, even like this also we can hold it. So for suppose this is a round workpiece. So this kind of round workpiece cannot be located between these two jaws. So here, okay, we can locate. It slip, it will come down. So point contact is less. And even in this direction also we cannot keep. So we can keep when high force is applied on that one, it will fall down. So that is why cylindrical components cannot be located. So one more thing I will tell you. If you see this one, this is a flat surface and it is held between two jaws. So where the contact area is more, contact area. So here contact area between the jaw and this one is more. Similarly, if you use this one, the contact area is less. Along its line, only at one point, at line you have contact. If it is perfect cylinder, so at one line only the fitting, that is that gripping takes place. So such cases, such to locate this kind of round work pieces, we are using this kind of holding device. This is V block. See this one, this is in the shape of V. So at bottom and top, both the sides you can use, but once only one side only we can use. See this one, this is the C clamp. This V block sides, it is having slots. This is one slot, this is another slot. In this slot, this see this one, this clamp is placed. So at the top you have this screw, and where the see this one on the V block, a cylindrical component can be placed. So if you apply the force from the top side, the cylindrical workpiece will not fall down. So whereas in this case if you see, if the cylindrical place is horizontally, if you apply the force vertically, the round pieces will fall down. Whereas in this case, it is not like that. So, where the workpiece is supported twice, here and both the sides. So, there are two surfaces. This is one surface, this is another surface. Between these two surfaces, the round workpiece is rigidly held. At the top, this is a clamp. So, by rotating the screw, this is C clamp, V block, this is a clamping screw. By rotating this one, the cylindrical workpieces can be rigidly held on the V block. See this one, the V block is a rectangular or square block with a V groove. V groove you have at top and bottom. V groove on one or both the sides. So one side and one side V blocks also we have. The angle of V is 60 degrees. So from this surface is 60 degrees. So the round workpiece is placed over this one. When it is rotated, when the screw is rotated, it will move downwards and the cylindrical workpieces are rigidly held. Next one. And so flat workpieces can be fixed on the bench vise. Cylindrical workpieces are fixed with the help of the V block and the C clamp. Next one. These are the measuring and marking tools. What are, see this, this is the tri-square. The tri-square, which is also known as engineer's tri-square. We also call that one as engineer's tri-square. It is having two pieces. See this one. One piece is called as beam, which is in large size. Next one is called as blade. So where the size of this one is less. So top one is called as beam. This one is called as blade. So this is the 90 degrees between them. The tri-square, which is also known as engineer tri-square, is a very important tool required for scribing straight lines at right angles to a true surface or testing the trueness of mutually normal surfaces. What is this one? See, this surface is between angle between these two surfaces is 90 degrees. It is also used to test the trueness of mutually normal surfaces. So for suppose one example I will tell you. If we see a corner of joint, corner of a table. So corner of table, if we see, there are two sides at the corner. So one corner is like that, we have the two corners. If it is a table, this is corner. At the corner, this surface should be 90 degrees, perpendicular to each other. To check this one, where we are using the tri-square, if it is tri-square, this is beam and blade, like that we can place. And one more thing is, this is also used to check the flatness of the surface. See this one. So if the top surface is flat, when it is placed like this, so if you see in this direction, you cannot see any gap between this one and between the beam and the top surface of the workpiece. For that one, we are using this tri-square, and in some applications for the marking also, we are using. It consists of a steel blade fitted in a steel stock rectangular cross section. See, this is size of this one is small. Size of this one, this thing is that its thickness is less than the thickness of this one. Thickness of this one is less than the thickness of this one. If you see the cross section of this one, this is square cross section. It appears just like a blade. So I can tell you one thing, that cross section of this one is 80 by 80, side of this one 80 mm. If you see this one, for this one, width is 80 mm, thickness is 30 mm. So that's why we are calling this one as blade, this one is as a beam. It is sufficiently hardened and tempered to suit the need. What is this hardened and tempered? See, generally steels are having continuously this kind of tri-squares are used in the work. So this is metal work. When they are continuously used, wear may takes place on the surfaces. So when the wear takes place on that one, accuracy will be reduced. So to avoid that one, what is to be done? The surfaces are to be made hard. So the surface can be made hard by the heat treatment process. So two types of heat treatment process we have. So one is hardening heat treatment, another one is tempering process. So by using the hardening and the tempering process, its hardness and strength can be improved. So we are finally, due to hardening and tempering process, hardness of this one will be increased, then the wear resistance will also be increased. So that's why the surfaces are made tempered and hardened.